An estimated 15% of Americans are betting on NFL games this season. And hey, if you're one of them, you're in the right spot. Let's welcome in Larry Hartstein, the senior analyst for SportsLine. And Larry, it's been a couple weeks since we last got to talk, but I want to know what your record is this deep into the season.
Yeah, good to see you again, Katie. 45-28 against the spread, 62%. Got 4 weeks of the regular season left in the playoffs, so let's finish it strong.
Well, one of the most anticipated matchups of Week 14 for the NFL, the San Francisco 49ers face the New Orleans Saints this week. So what's the most striking betting angle or trend that you're seeing for this powerhouse matchup?
It really is. A couple of 10-2 teams, the number one seed at stake, and 80% of the money coming in on the 49ers. This line was 3, now 2.5. I mean, basically people are saying the 49ers are a much better team because that home field edge for the Saints is usually 3, 3.5 points, and here they're only getting 2.5, so that's pretty striking. Plus, the 49ers have covered 4 straight as an underdog, including last week they go to Baltimore, which had been destroying everyone. They almost win, lose 20-17, and the Saints just 5-9 as home favorites against the number 3-7 in their last 10, 3-7 ATS last 10 home games, so a lot of things pointing to San Fran.
And Larry, as you handicap this must-see competition, how does the schedule spot come into play?
Very interesting, because the 49ers, they stayed in Florida. It's their second straight road game. They didn't come back from Baltimore, which is a very smart move because we've seen how that can impact a team doing 2 cross-country trips. So that's one thing going in their favor. But this was a violent game in Baltimore. I don't know if you saw that, but that was so physical. That was a championship heavyweight bout. Now to ask them to do that again at New Orleans, a tough place to play, that's one thing that might have you leaning Saints. But then if you think about what the Saints have played, they haven't played a defense like this. They've played the Falcons twice, the Bucks twice, the Jaguars, the Cardinals. I mean, they've been feasting on bad defenses. Now they play the number one team in total defense, the number two team in scoring defense, an entirely different challenge against the 49ers. So I can see great arguments on both sides.
I love how you explain that a little bit, because you can say all you want about teams going all out for every game, but really the 49ers have 2 back-to-back super difficult matchups ahead, so it's very interesting that you mentioned that. Thank you so much, Larry, for your expert analysis and for joining us this week and week by week throughout the NFL season. Hey, you can check out all of Larry's picks on SportsLine. This game kicks off. Check out all the action on Sunday. Katie Johnston for CBS Local Sports.